of the Northern Entertainment. Welcome to another episode of Deer Valley. I'm not gonna talk much here because there's really not much new I can tell you about Deer Valley that you haven't heard already. It's going to be more of a, I don't know, silent me driving a train kind of deal. But I did want to talk about a couple of the things that have come with the latest update. Let me quickly just check where we're going. You can see that here already. This used to be the highest setting on the vegetation, but if you go now to settings and graphics, you will see that that is no longer the case. What was ultra is now high. So if we go now on everything onto very high and ultra and so on and so forth, and put real-time reflections on as well. And that is not recommended for anybody who uses this with VR. Just keep that in mind. But if we put that now all on ultra, then you can see that the game looks a lot nicer. There's a lot more that's going on. We are going to hook up to the train that is on 7 Sierra here, Bravo 7 Sierra. Just this one here. So we might as well set. That one is correct. That one is correct. Now I did notice that the vegetation now is a lot, growing on the tracks as well. That's quite interesting. There we go. Okay, that's good. That is good as well. Oh, we just have to pull out here and go. We are to drag a train. It's a logistical haul, so you can see here we're gonna hook up to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 cars, and we're gonna drag them. Actually, I can show you here. We're gonna drag them to the Gutzon Factory Town. I'm gonna leave that here. We're gonna look on the world map quickly. We are, as you can see, we are actually, can't I? Okay, we are here at the steel mill. We have to go to Gutzon Factory Town. So we're gonna back up. We're gonna go ahead. We're back up into the main. Like so. Here we go. And of course, this update is not the... this is not the final update that we're all waiting for. I'm just gonna jump off the train here, do what I need to do. There we go, wonderful. But yeah, of course, everybody is kind of waiting for the... everybody is waiting for the simulation update, because the simulation update is going to add so much nice and new things to Deer Valley. One, of course, being the fact that you can actually blow your drive motors if you overload them. And so many other things that a lot of us were asking for a long time. And of course, keep in mind, this is not like a train sim world. This is not like a train Yeah, not like Train Sim World 2, where you have real life routes and real life engines and all these things. That is not what Derail Valley is all about. Derail Valley is about having fun, being in approachable yet realistic simulator of rail operations. Definitely not prototypical rail simulator, let me add that too, because well, I guess it's as prototypical as you want it to be, but there's a couple of things that they have at the moment that are not the same way you would expect. I just realized something. This would have brought us to this would have brought us to 8 Sierra and not 7 Sierra. So that's why I quickly changed it with my radio. And one of the things that you might have noticed is it actually highlights now the switch that you are aiming at. How very nice is that? All right, let's get in here. Got the air hooked up. Open the angle cocks. Excuse me. Yeah, with that, we are literally ready to go now. So we're gonna go pretty much straight out. Gonna continue on down the line, and then at the only intersect, or at the only switch that we're gonna encounter, we will be making a turn towards the east. So really easy, nothing super exciting really. I do hope that eventually I will be able to get the big diesel pusher. Or the big diesel engines. That would be really nice, but we'll see. Yeah, it looks great though, doesn't it? The new vegetation looks just amazing. Absolutely amazing. So 70. Harbor. Yeah, we have a max of 70 here that we can go, but I think 65 is just fine. I remember when this game was like almost brand new in its first iterations. You couldn't even begin to think about going as fast as 60 for the most part, because it would just simply derail you right there. There's a lot of vegetation on the tracks, I noticed. Oh, 100. We can go 100. Not with this train though, because that would just cause all kinds of issues. So you can see here, we are coming up here on a nice straightaway along the river valley. Curious how much they're gonna slow us down for those S turns that are coming up. I think I can see it here. It's still 70. But that might change right away. I am going to slow down though, for the simple reason that once we are past here, there is pretty much a 90 degree turn that's coming up after this bridge. Right there. .45 I think is the safe speed. It also will give us some time to change the switch if need be. So 400 meters till we hit that switch. And I think we are good. Gonna stay at 40 kilometers per hour for now. Just let it roll. Yeah, we're good. And here we go. As you can see, it's 50. And then we're gonna be slowing down right away as soon as we are over that bridge that leads us into Goods and Factory Town. Because we have to figure out whereabouts we're gonna land. Whereabouts we're gonna stop, not land. Of course, with the incline of 1.1, we wanna also throttle a little bit up so we don't lose too much speed. And you can see it's still losing speed. Because this is a rather long it's a rather long train. It's a rather long consist for this little shunter. I did notice that we didn't go much up on temperature, which is good, because if we run the engine too hot, then we end up damaging the engine. And that's what we don't want. So might as well at this point have a look at the station map here for Goods Factory. So there's the transfer. Let's see where they want us. Bravo 3 Sierra. So that's where we're gonna come in. So that's actually good, because that means that we can unhook right from the get-go when we come in. See how far out we are. You might have heard that that was wheel slip, meaning that we have too much power from the motors on the drive wheels. And that means that the wheels are starting to slip on the steel, because obviously steel tires or steel wheels on steel rails, that doesn't have the greatest of a friction to begin with. All right, there's the tunnel. Which means that Goods and Factory Town is here on the other side of the tunnel right away. And you know what? No, we're gonna be stopping here. Because we need to figure out where exactly we're gonna go now. Alright, here we are. Let's have a quick look here at the station map. So, Bravo will be the first one. So this is where we're coming in from. You see it here. So this is going to be 3 Sierra. Yeah, it's a good thing that we stopped here, because I have to switch this one over. That brings us here. And then we're gonna go onto this track here, and that's 3 Sierra, and that is really all we need to do. As I said, this is one of those runs that's easy money. Now, you might have noticed that I actually preloaded or front-loaded the engines. Meaning I put the throttle up. And by that, preloading the engines, making sure that we don't roll back when I release the brakes. And the reason that that works so well, of course, is because this is a diesel electric engine, meaning that the diesel motor is really just powering a big generator, which in turn powers the drive motors on the engine. All right, we're good here. So I am just going to do this here at this point and bring the remote up. And this way I can ensure that we are actually off the other track. And we can just have a look here and see train is coming. There we go. Train is now safely on the track. I'm gonna take a little picture here. Beautiful. Now we're gonna grab our contract. There it is. And the last thing we're gonna do before going into this building here, by the way, if you ever look for the building that gives you the contracts, look for the building with the green beacon. So first of all, we're gonna be closing the angle cog. And we're gonna be retrieving this, hook that up here. Just like so. And then we're gonna go over to the station master and get our monies. Dunzos! Yeah, and we might as well. We might as well pay. Yeah, unfortunately, I can't do that. Confirm that. Wonderful. Now we can go back and go to our licenses, see if I can own or if I can get anything. We have 25,000. No, unfortunately, that's not gonna work. We need 5,000 more. But this is all I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Until next time, Northern Alex signing off. Thanks for watching. God bless.